What's up, guys? In this tutorial, I will show you how to play Punishing Grey Raven on your Windows PC or Mac. This should be quite an easy tutorial. For more information, click on the first link in the description below. To play Punishing Grey Raven on your PC, you must use an Android emulator, such as BlueStacks. BlueStacks is a popular choice to play mobile games on your PC, as it's optimized for playing mobile games. Click on the first link in the description to get to this page. From here, make sure to download the BlueStacks 5 setup installer to your system. This should only take a second to complete, and you can follow the install wizard to install the application to your system. After the installation is complete, BlueStacks should open up automatically. Next, open up your Play Store and ensure that you're logged in with your Google account. Search for Punishing Grey Raven and download the game to your BlueStacks emulator. This might take a few minutes to complete, depending on your network connection. While downloading the game, you should take a look at your emulator settings. Click on this gear icon to access these settings. In the Performance tab, you should set these according to your PC's performance. Allocate a high amount of CPU cores if you don't have a lot of other applications running in the background. The same goes for your memory allocation. For users with 4 GB or less RAM, set this option to low. Under Performance mode, make sure to set this option to balanced. This will reduce the memory and CPU usage if your PC lags or you otherwise encounter low performance. I prefer to enable the high FPS option and set the frame rate of the emulator according to my screen refresh rate. If unsure about the refresh rate, right-click your desktop and select Display Settings. From here, make sure that the correct display is selected. Scroll down and click on Advanced Display. This will allow you to preview your refresh rate and change it if you want. Also, if you troubleshoot performance issues, make sure to enable the FPS counter option. In your display settings, set the display orientation to landscape and choose a fitting resolution to play Punishing Grey Raven on your monitor. You can also adjust the size of this window by dragging its corners. You can leave the other settings to the default option and play Punishing Grey Raven to see how well it runs on your PC. You will be required to download a patch when first starting the game. You can then choose a server location and log into your account to continue playing where you left off on your mobile device. While in-game, click on the keyboard icon in your BlueStacks menu bar on the right-hand side. This will allow you to enable and disable the on-screen controls option. This will help you figure out which keyboard keys to use to play Punishing Grey Raven on your PC or Mac. After completing the initial tutorial, navigate to your in-game settings. Adjust the background music, effects, and voice volume for your device. In the graphics section of your settings, you will see that these are set to the recommended settings based on your system performance. Sometimes, these settings are set too high, as you might have other applications running on your system. If you encounter any lag or stuttering while in-game, then make sure to reduce your overall graphics quality setting from high to medium, for example. Below, adjust the resolution of the game to the size of your BlueStacks window. You might want to lower the shadows option as well as your in-game reflections. Both of these options don't add much visual quality and can reduce your performance by a lot. Make sure that the in-game frame rate cap is set too high, and set the other settings to your personal preference. You can also adjust these settings while playing the game to see how they reflect in your gameplay. In the button position settings, navigate to the Keyboard Keys tab, where, when enabled, you can preview and change your current keyboard layout for the game. In the Account section, proceed to log in with your account to save your progress or to continue playing. All of these steps and more information will be available in my extensive guide linked in the description below. I hope this helped you out. Leave a comment if you have any questions, and see you in the next one.